Can you imagine what happens under hudud if there is selective prosecution? And if you follow hudud, I do not profess to be an expert. I'm just taking from what the panel say, yeah? So there may be exceptions. You have four male Muslim adult witnesses or who are just characters of just character. And if they give evidence of a particular crime, that is sufficient proof of that crime. If there was collusion in bringing a charge, there was selective prosecution in that collusive charge, and you do not have a corrupt-free judiciary, is that conducive environment? That's all you need to ask yourself. And you know, looking at what has been happening in Malaysia, you can recall instances of abuse of power, of detention, ISA. Who does that? It's the authorities. The authorities that we, under the Constitution, have provided a duty to enforce these laws. We have selective prosecution. Rampant corruption. So just like all of them were saying that hudud law must be applied for everyone because that is the Islamic principle, equality. Irrespective of what the Deputy Chief Minister of Kelantan said, that it is unequal, but that is acceptable for them, right? It applies to the powerful right up to the poor. You can't have it with corruption because the powerful, as we know, what is our biggest lament? Hardly any powerful people are caught and charged and convicted for corruption. So these are questions you ask yourself. That is all.